Welcome back, and we're flying the Douglas DC-6B again. Today we're flying from Fort Lauderdale, Florida to Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. So let's get our flight plan set up and get everybody buckled in and get on our way. This is also going to be a SimBuddy virtual airline client flight, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. As you can see, it's a little bit cloudy, but for the most part, we should get above it. They're fairly low-lying clouds for today. No rain in sight, so should be a nice flight. If I can ever get the flight plan working properly. Always have I got spoiled using the standard FMC, and now I'm back to using the Garmin 430. And it sometimes fight me. I've got to remember how to do things. So please bear with me while I get to it. Okay, as you can see, the SimBuddy client, and we'll get right here and load our passengers.
Closed.
Door warning lights.
Door warning lights.
Out.
Out.
Gear pins.
Gear pins.
Removed.
Three on board. Removed.
Seat belts.
Three on board. Seat belts and pedals.
Adjusted.
Adjusted.
Throttles.
Throttles.
Set to idle.
Set to idle.
Propellers.
Propellers.
Forward and three.
Forward and three. Before start checks complete. Start engines.
Okay, so we'll be getting ready here to start our engines pretty quick.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard. If you haven't already done so, please stow your carry-on luggage underneath the seat in front of you or in an overhead bin. Please take your seat and fasten your seatbelt. And also make sure your seat back and folding trays are in their full upright position. If you are seated next to an emergency exit, please read carefully the special instructions card located by your seat. We remind you that this is a non-smoking... Captain, all passengers are on board.
Very good. So now we can start getting ready to fly.
Flight attendants, doors to automatic on cross check.
Yeah, we start with engine 3. That's
Captain, doors are set to automatic and cross checked.
that's the engine that gives us our power. Then we'll do engine 4 and then 2 and 1. And we've got 4 good engines running. Flight plan is complete.
Flight attendants, seats for takeoff.
So, we'll be ready to move here shortly.
Start selecting boost pumps. Off and off. Battery switch. Plane battery. Generators and inverters. Checked and on. Emergency lights. Armed. Ground power. Removed. After start checks complete.
And there's our bird. Douglas DC-6B. Four radial engines, 18 cylinders each, putting out a total of 2,500 horsepower per engine. Built in the 1940s. Just a fun old lady to fly. Cruises quite nicely at 210 to 220 knots and has a climb rate most happy at about 500 to 1,000 feet. In reality, it takes 3 people to fly this airplane. pilot, co-pilot, and then flight engineer.
Boost pumps? Boost pumps on low. Fuel selector and crossfeed. Main tanks and crossfeed off. Autopilot and carb heat. Off and cold. Hydraulic system. Down, forward, pressure and quantity checked. Okay. Flaps 20. Flaps set 20. Windows and turbine. Closed and on. Controls. Gust lock released. Free. Pitot heater. On. Mixture and cowl flaps. Rich and locked. Set. Transponder. On. Landing lights. Extended and on. Before takeoff checks complete.
Okay, on the runway here, everything's looking good. Flaps are at 20. So, let's do a dry weather takeoff checklist. Prepare for takeoff.
Stabilized. Cowl flaps set.
Full power, please.
Going full power.
Good.
Full power set.
Brakes released. Speed is alive. V1 and rotate. She doesn't climb fast, but she climbs steady.
Positive rate, gear up.
Gear selected up.
Start our left turn to get on heading.
Flaps up.
Flaps going up. Flaps are up.
Meter power.
Setting meter power, 48 inches, 2600 RPM.
Meter
meter power set.
Climb power.
Setting climb power. Climb power set.
After takeoff checklist, please.
Okay. After takeoff checks complete.
Is that our autopilot? Click on localizer and that should keep us on track. Okay, so climbing nicely. Once we get up to about 8,500 feet, between 8,500 and 9,000 feet, I'll go ahead and let the passengers unbuckle and move about the cabin. Waypoint. DC-6 is performing quite nicely. Or as I say, everything is in nominal positions. It's a good looking airplane in the air. Old but elegant. I'd say it's like her pilot me, but that would be pushing things a little bit. And my co-pilot agrees. Don't push my luck, just fly the plane. Which George seems to be doing quite nicely. George is an old way of saying autopilot. So we fly over Florida, on up towards Myrtle Beach. We'll head up to Jacksonville and make a right turn, head out over the ocean, and come back on land just south of Charleston, and then head up to Myrtle Beach. We'll be in and out of these scattered clouds pretty much all the way.
Set cruise power, please.
Setting cruise power. Power is set. Cruise checks are complete.
Quick look at the fuel gauges there, so I'll be making an adjustment on the fuel levers here shortly. During these flights, what we'll do is we'll switch the fuel levers so that the outboard engines and the inboard engines are never working on the same set of fuel tanks. We switch between the auxiliaries and the mains in order to maintain balance. Just one of the things you have to keep an eye on in these old aircraft. No computers to do it for us anymore. Or anymore back then. Well, keep the passengers happy. Let's get ready to start feeding them food. Full stomach makes for a happy passenger. As long as it doesn't get too bumpy. Very good. I don't expect any rough weather. So they should be happy. So we're going about 210 knots at about just under 8,600 feet. Straight and level, flying smooth, all engines operating properly. So we're cruising right along just as we should. And as you can see, 23 minutes left on this leg till our next waypoint. And another outside look at our sweet lady. Wave to the air crew. They always like people waving at them. She's the queen of the skies for our Air America Duex. And today's flight is for subcontracted with Solus Wings, the national. Solus Wings, a virtual airline, has two branches, the regional for shorter flights, and the national, where we fly pretty much just about anywhere in the country. Use an aircraft like this DC-6 for the nostalgic flyer.
As we get close to Jacksonville, Florida, head up the coast of Myrtle Beach. Everything seems to be working fine. Hope Cape's that way.
And the other branch is the, I said regional, where we use the smaller jets and smaller aircraft. The E-1000 turboprop and the Eclipse 550, little twin jet five-seaters. We also have for the national the 737-800s. So
okay, 36 miles, and we'll make another course adjustment. We'll be heading straight over the water here shortly.
And we've made our turn onto the new leg, and we're headed directly over the ocean, heading up towards Charleston, where again we make another course correction, another waypoint.
Captain, the in-flight entertainment has
ended. Okay, start a second movie. Keep them happy. And from Charleston, we head up to Myrtle Beach. Very good. We'll keep those people happy.
Yeah, it's a pretty day out.
Captain, we have finished serving food.
Very good. Yeah, we can get ready to serve them a second round of drinks. As I said, I'm not sure we have time to finish it, but excellent. And when the VSR gets to 500, we're going to start our descent. And we've got about 15, 16 minutes left in the flight before we land. Coming on shore here about Charleston. Charleston's just up the coast a little bit. Just see the edge of it sticking out there on the right. That might be Charleston Executive Airport. I don't think it's the International. Could be wrong. Minutes to our next waypoint. As my beautiful co-pilot brings me a wonderfully delicious cup of coffee. Nothing like a good hot cup of French roast to make a pilot feel just spiffy. A cup of Joe.
Well, I was actually very surprised at that last heading correction. Onto our next leg of our flight. Didn't excite or worry the passengers. Normally a turn like that, they get all excited and scream and everything else. But not this time. Which is very good. Alright, we're going to start our descent. Turn off our altitude hold.
26 inches, please.
Setting 26 and inches.
Adjust. The descent to where we like it.
Set.
Descent checklist, please.
Altimeters and flight instruments, cross-checked. Seatbelt signs on. On. Engine blowers low. Low. Descent checks are complete.
Very good. And eventually we're going to be at just over 500 feet a minute descent. Vertical speed indicator. And as you can see, KMYR is dead ahead.
Flight attendants, prepare the cabin for landing.
And we'll be making a right turn to head out over the ocean. Turn around and come in to land on into Myrtle Beach. Passengers are seated, belted in, everything's looking good.
Captain, the cabin is secure.
Flight attendants, seats for landing.
Lights are on. Old girl likes to float a little bit, so we'll be flying her pretty much right down to the runway. A little bit of a crosswind, not too bad. Start our flare, and we're down. Hardly felt it. Reversers. Use the power up to help slow us down. Turn the reversers off, and we'll let her roll a little bit to the exit point, and we make our right turn, head towards the terminal. There we go. And get the flaps back up. Clean the airplane up. Get ready to get our passengers out of here. Brake on.
resume your duties. Flight attendants, doors to manual.
All right, we'll get the passengers offloaded. Yeah, once that's done, we can end this flight. All right. Passengers are gone. So, hope you had fun. I sure enjoyed making the flight. Hope you enjoyed it too. It's always fun flying the DC-6B. And so, until next time, safe flying.